Welcome back to the channel, guys. So today gonna be an interesting one actually. This is my first meal of the day. Just did 3 clients in the morning. Heading to a different gym that I normally train from today, and I'm gonna be training with one of my online clients, Dave. So he actually lives out in Dubai. I met him out here actually, and then we've been working together now for the best part of the year actually. I think we started working together around about February time. Been on a lean bulking phase for the whole period, and we definitely made some progress over that time. And we're going to be training legs today. So all my clients I get on well with, I have a good relationship. I feel like that's very important as a coach and a client, that you get on well. And I tried to link up with him. We try and do it weekly, but it doesn't always happen because our schedules don't align. But yeah, this is what I like to do if I'm free and I've got some time. Train together with my clients, make sure that we're pushing each other. He pushes me as well as I push him. And yeah, hopefully we're in for a good session today. Current physique update. Looking a little bit more body fat, but still holding decent condition. Trying to keep the body fat in check this off season, while still trying to obviously increase and build muscle, which is arguably more difficult than when you're in a dieting phase, I think, because when you're in a dieting phase, you're going in one direction, right? And the goal is to just pull off as much body fat as possible, make sure the weight's dropping each week. Whereas when you're trying to increase muscle mass, the rate is a lot slower, and like probably 10x slower than fat loss, right? When we're talking about building muscle. So the margins are really, really small. And I feel like myself, definitely, and most of the people, we try to stick to that at the beginning, and then you get pissed off, and then you just end up going way over the other direction, which is gaining too much body fat. So it's about just stay in the game for a long period of time, you know, slowly increase up. Basically, yeah, spending periods of time maintaining, but then just making sure, like, over a long period of time, the weight is slowly going upwards, right? And when I say slowly, I'm talking like maybe 1 pound per month, let's say, which is tiny, right? I mean, I can gain a pound in a day. So that's why, I mean, you're just kind of maintaining, and then you can increase a little bit, and so on like that. And then you keep cardioing. That's also cardio steps, activity. It's going to help minimize fat gain, and obviously some high days calories wise, but then also some low days as well. Anyway, enough rambling for me. It's now 11, so my client should be here, and we'll get into this leg session. So we're in Max Burn Gym. It's in Alcoz area. Decent equipment actually, to be fair. I trained here years ago, and then I came back recently to train with my client a couple of weeks ago. It's not bad gym to fit.
Stop working out, you get muscle atrophy.
It comes back, you stop training for a bit and then you get back in there. You get it back in there.
Yeah, you get muscle memory, but what I'm saying, you have to keep always train. You can't, even if you build a physique in a year, you can't stop it. So you have to learn to love the process.
Yeah.
You've got to learn to like enjoy training with someone, because you're going to be doing it regardless. To hold that physique, you're always going to do it. Like,
I read an article once that said, once you build a fair amount of muscle, maintenance comes into it. You have to do less training to maintain it.
Yeah, of course.
Obviously more training to keep it up.
Yeah, to get the physique, you've got to put a lot more work in and hard to get it, yeah. But when to maintain it, you can slack off. But you still have to do something.
Look, you know what? No,
you've got to stay in the game though, haven't you? Like, regardless. Like,
you have to do something
hard, that's right. But, and that's why you need to somewhat enjoy it, right? You need to like training at least. Not, you don't have to love it, but like,
I'm going to
that's right.
Not
one.
Not
one
and a half, it's like 2 or 4 pounds.
2 or 4, you've had a... You showed me a minute the salt will be high and all of you. A couple of that. Yeah, we don't think it's too fancy.
No.
It's good though,
I think the calories I'm on put to better use.
3-5, yeah?
Yeah, like 3-4 in reality.
Your body's just more optimal, like everything, more efficient.
What I tend to do is I monitor my carbs and my fat.
Yeah.
And then proteins, minimum 200.
Yeah.
I get like 220, 230, I don't really care. But minimum 200.
Yeah, minimum 200.
Carbs in around the 500.
Thank you. the hand off my bottom. That's enough. Don't need it. Yeah, I'm stronger, Fred. You're stronger, ha, isn't you?
Yeah. rusty green shirt.
It's funny how it changes, isn't it? I've always been strong in the chest. Let's push this for another rep if you can, yeah? I'm here. Got a spot. Quads. That's it. Keep the knees close in as well, yeah. That's good. Much better. Good, strong. That's it. Quality now, quality. Three, yeah, these are good reps. Yeah, perfect. Pain. Yeah. Strong now. Come on. Power. Keep going. Keep it moving. And drive, yeah. And again, volume. Straight in. And drive, yeah. Easy. Three more minimum. Let's go. One. And again, two. Let's go.
Yeah, one more.
Go on, push. Go on, and then.
Yep.
Good set. Better. Last set, is it?
Yeah, I want to take it off. Take it off.
No, this will be good, I think.
This will be good.
Yeah.
Right, training session wrapped up with my client Dave here. Good leg session then. So Dave, been coaching you now for the best part of this year, really. We started coaching back in February. We've gained like 15 pounds, just over 15 pounds. In a lean progressive bulk. Body composition slightly higher body fat, but not really noticeable. Like not noticeable in terms of like, we definitely haven't built 15 pounds of body fat, have we? That's for sure. So how has the coaching process been for you since we started coaching?
It's been good, man. It's been, best part of the year that we've been together. It's been the accountability that I've needed to get five sessions a week in when I've been busy at work. Consistent with my food, that's been the biggest thing. I think food is the area where I get busy at work, I tend to slip and I'll miss a meal, and you've kept me accountable on the calories that we've set. But overall, I'd say I'm 15 pounds up and only a couple of pound body fat, so it's been good.
Yeah, that's really good progress. And yeah, that's what is the biggest thing, is accountability, right? Like in the past, we all have our off days, right? But you don't want that off day to turn into an off week.
Exactly.
Or someone like that. You just got to get straight back on track. And if you've got someone in your corner that's just giving you that little bit of a nudge, come on, we need to be better. Like, you're going to have days where you miss calories, but we've got to minimize that, right? And that's where that accountability comes in. And it's been good. And obviously, we're going to go into a dieting phase at some point. We're going to keep this train going as everything's feeling good at the moment, right? Like, the training's good, energy's good. So we're going to continue to ride this wave and then eventually reveal the goods when we go into that dieting phase. But no, good session today anyway.
And, as always.
Yeah, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Subscribe and like the video. See you in the next one.